What's up? Welcome into the Flames Signing Day Special 2017. Alongside Alan York, I'm Matt Warner, and what a day for the future of the Liberty football program. So many of the young men that we introduced to you this afternoon are going to play a big role in the future of this Liberty squad.
Exactly right, Matt. Got a great show in store for the next hour. We're going to break down all 15 signees, including the two midseason enrollees. Earlier today, head coach Turner Gill met with the media, and we got his press conference right now.
Well, it's a thrilling day today. I want to say thank the Lord for the opportunity that he has blessed us with. Start off with this class here. I first want to say about, we got four guys from the state of Virginia, and that puts a big smile on my face as far as our coaches did a tremendous job of going out here in-state, very, very quality guys, not only on the football field, but also in the classroom setting. A couple other stats before I get involved with each individual guy. 2017, we had 20 official visits, and 15 of them committed to us. So 75% of the people who came on our campus, they committed. I think that's a great ratio as far as being able to do that. So last year, we were really even better than that. We had 90%. We had 18 out of 20. We've been right around about 20 official visits and getting 17, 18, 15, or 16 commitments there as we've been coming in. In general about the class, I think the one thing that I really impressed by, they have a very, very good, probably the best, I would say the best football IQ that we've had in the 5 years that I've been here. And you say, well, what do you mean by football IQ? When we talk to our high school coaches, we talk to the kid, and when we sit down with them and talk about football, they were very knowledgeable about the game. They were very passionate about the game, but very, very knowledgeable of knowing what to do, how to do, and talking the good football language. And so that's what I mean by football IQ. So really every single young man that come through here has that. The other thing about this class is athletic. Even our offensive linemen can run, get down the field. They can get to the second level, get to the third level. We saw guys doing that. And so those were some of the things that we were looking for in their attributes as football players, as far as on the offensive line and in the defensive line. Can they run? Are they athletic? Are they able to jump over people's legs and still get to where they need to go? And we see all of our offensive linemen and defensive linemen in this class, they showed that on tape, and they all are very, very good students. So we do have a very, very good class. Let me talk about the defense first. I'm going to go by each one person here. I'm going to start with the D-line, Elijah Mitchell from Bayside High School there in Virginia Beach. 6'3", about 300 pounds, a guy that was very, very dominating. Again, he used his hands very, very well, very, very physical. He can go from sideline to sideline as far as being able to run and get the ball carrier. He understands the blocking schemes. He was able to get on the board and talk about that. So he was a great example as far as a guy with a great football IQ. Jayod Sanders, boy, I'm excited about this young man. This young man here, I think our coach did a fantastic job to get him. He's from Tallahassee, Florida, from Leon High School. Leon High School always have a lot of great football players coming out of their school, and we were able to get him in here. He's a guy that's long, got 210, 215 pounds now, 6'2". I think he's going to be a tremendous player. I think you guys have been here in the 5 years. We've always have had pretty good defensive ends, and I feel that he's going to be one of those guys that's going to fall right into their situation. He's a quick twitch guy, great length, very explosive. We kind of use a saying that we were looking at him on tape, plays with his hair on fire. So he plays with a lot of passion. Moving on to the linebackers, Remington Green. He's from King George, Virginia, up there by Fredericksburg area. He came to our camp, did a fantastic job in our camp, very, very physical player, very passionate, plays tight end, played linebacker, can run and do a lot of good things in there. So he ran from sideline to sideline, and whenever he struck people, everybody went backwards. So a very, very competitive guy, very competitive in the classroom, very competitive on the football field. So he is truly a guy that we feel very, very fortunate to have on our team. Amari Jenkins, a guy from Westport High School there in Ocala, Florida, really played safety. He's going to be a guy that we believe is going to be a linebacker with his size, got a great frame, got long arms, and he can run, and he will strike you. And so he's done a great thing as far as showing that on tape. Plays basketball, very athletic in basketball, pretty good football player, pretty good basketball player. Again, we kind of went out in the woods there in the Florida area and found him, and we're very, very fortunate our coaches were on top of him. He's about 6 foot, probably 195 pounds as far as Amari Jenkins. Corners, Kamani Donaldson from Mundy's Hill High School there in the Atlanta area. He's about 6 foot, about 165, 170 pounds. Little guy, but, man, he showed us that he will strike you. Has great ball skills. When the ball's in the air, that was one of our qualities. We're looking at defensive backs, not just looking at guys that can actually run and hit and do all those things, but can they have ball skills? You know, you want to get INTs. You just don't want to get the pass breakups. I think he's a guy that really can play multiple positions. He could play offense, defense, and a whole lot of different positions, but we're going to play him at corner. Keith Best, a guy really is a unique young man. He had a lot of FBS offers. Unfortunately, there he got hurt in his season early on, and so people kind of fell off of him a little bit there. But from Tucker High School in the Atlanta area, you know, 6'2", probably about 180, 85 pounds. I think he can be the steal of the class, because I think this guy has a tremendous upside, and we're fortunate in the blessings and things about him as far as being able to get him in our program. If you want to say what is his football skills like, those that know our team there, Chris Turner, type of guy that can play corner, long and range, got great ball skills, can run, physical, and do all those types of things. So he is definitely a press man type corner. Safeties, Aaron Pierre. A guy from Cambridge Christian High School there in Tampa, Florida. 6 foot, about 205, 210 pounds. He played running back, played safety, played linebacker, a lot of different positions, and really, really is an outstanding footballer. He could play running back if we wanted him to do that. But we're going to play him at safety. I think he has great length, great size, great ball skills, too, as far as being able to do a lot of things. He gave his life to Christ this past summer. So he's just a dynamic guy, and really he committed to us really fairly early in the summer. Runs track and does all those things too. Now I'm going to move on over here to the offensive side of the ball here. Start with the offensive line. Cooper McCaw, a guy from Faith Christian High School there in Grapevine, Texas. 6'5", probably about 275, 280 pounds right now. This guy here can run over people. He's very athletic, from a state championship team. And he really loves the Lord. I'm just so glad we hung on to him for a long time, because he committed to us a fairly early in the process. He has been on our campus three times. So he's a guy that definitely loves Liberty University. I think he has the great qualities of being a leader. He's another tremendous person that got on the board with him. He knows how to talk the football language. He understands all the different blocking schemes, the different things on the defensive side of the ball. So we really feel outstanding about his potential. Tristan Schultz, another offensive lineman there. He's from Virginia, went to Fork Union. He's actually originally from Culver, Indiana, Culver County High School there where he's from. But, man, he's 6'4", 285 pounds. We got a chance to see him do some one-on-one blocks, and he's just a physical guy that plays with a little aggression in this game of football. And he's a leader. I think he can step up and do a lot of good things on the field and off the football field. So I think Tristan Schultz is going to be a guy that can come in here and compete right away on trying to get a job as far as playing this season. Tight end. This was one of our biggest needs going into. We lost three tight ends this past year, guys who played a lot of football. And I really, really feel great about these two guys here that we got. Pronounce his name is Fidel. And it's O'Bafin is the way you pronounce his last name. Fidel O'Bafin from Douglas County High School down in the Atlanta area. He had some FBS offers, too. We were able to beat some people on him. Smart, explosive. They played him a lot as a receiver-type guy. They put him out one-on-one. They ran a lot of tunnel screens with him. He was breaking tackle, making people miss, and then he showed great speed at a 6'2", 6'3", 220, 225 pounds, a tremendous upside. Only played 2 years of football. His family's from Nigeria. His dad actually still is over in Nigeria and working. His mom's over here and as a nurse and doing a lot of things here. So it's that guy's a fantastic athlete. And we anticipate him to compete for an opportunity to play this year. another guy, Jerome Jackson, another tremendous athlete, 6'4", 6'5". He's about 215. Him and Fidel are almost similar in a way. They can catch the ball, make things happen. They're going to be some big, gigantic guys before it's all over with in 3 or 4 years, as we're going to have Coach Gillespie get a hold of them. Wide receivers, Caleb Coleman. Caleb Coleman is a guy who is long, great speed. You know, he's from D.C. I didn't count him in Virginia, but you can definitely count him in Virginia just being up north there. Great length, quickness for his size. He's kind of a guy that's long, but he has quick feet. And you usually don't see that very often as far as in a wide receiver with that type of length. D.J. Stubbs, another guy from Florida, University Christian High School, tremendous speed, punt returner, kickoff returner, make people miss, shows a great burst, shows excellent speed, and being able to do things in a great way. So back-to-back state championship as far as with his high school. So he's from a winning program, and the coaches talk about him as being an outstanding leader. Running back there, Frank Boyd, a guy from Virginia, Manchester High School there in the Richmond area. Very, very exciting player is probably the way to describe him. 5'11", 5'10", about 180 pounds, runs over people. He can get the jump cut in the hole, and then he shows a great burst. That's probably the exciting thing about him. When people make cuts, but sometimes they can't make a cut and then be bursting through the hole. He's shown that on tape several different times. And again, we held on him at the last minute. Some people try to come on him late, but he did sign with us, and we're excited about him. Quarterback position there, Mason Cunningham, junior college kid there. He's already here now. He came from Northeast Mississippi. He's actually in high school, played ball at Shelbyville, Tennessee. More of a dual threat guy, can run, can throw. 6 foot, about 190, 95 pounds, and did a great job there at Northeast Mississippi Junior College. Good arm strength. He's accurate. He can throw on the run very, very well, and he can take off running. So he's a guy that has tremendous leadership. Then I'm going to finish up here. We had some really a great job by our staff. We got some walk-on guys that I want to mention here real quick here that I really feel great about them too. The offensive side of the ball, a guy by the name of Michael Bollinger from Bowling Springs High School in Bowling Springs, South Carolina. He's about 6'1", 220 pounds. Very good athlete, very aggressive, and is going to be coming in here and help us at the tight end position. Another young man by the name of Austin Mock, who is actually a long snapper from right here at Liberty Christian Academy. 6'2", 215 pounds, and very, very accurate in what he does as far as his snaps. And again, we definitely feel like he can fit into us. His dad played here at LU. On the defensive side, as far as the walk-ons, Ty Most, from a linebacker from Lord Botetourt, there in outside of Roanoke, Virginia. He's played a lot of positions. We're going to play him here at the linebacker, a physical kid, and an outstanding student. Mason Walk, he is a defensive lineman from Liberty Christian Academy here in Lynchburg. 6'1", 225 pounds, state wrestling champion here, hard worker. Again, a tremendous football IQ that he has. Last guy here is Elijah Cook, a defensive lineman, Patrick Henry High School in Roanoke. 6 foot, 225 pounds. We're going to have him as a defensive lineman. So he has great family ties to LU. So we're thrilled about this class. I think our coach has done a tremendous job of finding the guys that can be a right fit here and continuing to building champions for Christ the way Christ wants us to do it, both on the field and off the field. Open up for some questions.
Coach, want to start with Mason Cunningham. The quarterback, bringing in an experienced guy like that, what does that kind of do to the state of the position right now? Do you foresee it kind of being a little bit more of an open competition heading into spring, or what does that do for Stefan Masha? Foresee him maybe moving to another position? Just your thoughts.
Yeah, we've officially made a Stefan Masha has moved to wide receiver, where there's not going to be any competition as far as who's going to be our starting quarterback. Stephen Buckshot Calvert is our starting quarterback going into our season. Mason Cunningham understands that. Rudd Yerrick understands that. We've talked to all the people that's been involved. And again, we're just trying to make sure because of Stephon Masha moving a receiver, continue to have our enough depth at the quarterback position.
Just to clarify on Cunningham, does he have 3 years of eligibility remaining?
Has 3 years. He'll technically have four to play three. He has a redshirt year. So he was a qualifier coming out of high school, and then he played this year in the fall. And so he technically can redshirt in the fall if he want to do that. So four to play three.
And Bess, the guy that had ACL injury, mm-hmm. Where is he in his recovery time on that? Do you think he'd be ready to play this season?
We don't know all the – I mean, I know some of the detail, but I don't want to anticipate. I think there's a chance for him. I guess I'll put it in that sense as far as being able to play this upcoming fall. I think he'll have a chance to do that. And we're just going to take it step by step. And, you know, I think he's a guy that's very, very excited about the opportunity that he has here at Liberty University. I think he's a great fit.
Offensive line-wise, that was an area of concern at the end of the year. You signed two guys. Are you planning on the players who redshirted this past year to make an impact and have these guys, particularly Schultz, come in and push for some depth issues?
Well, I think we did have some redshirt guys, and we had a couple guys that didn't play last year, Micah Hendelman for one. So I think we have enough bodies and people there, just as long as they can get healthy. Ernst Anderson, some people, again, he didn't play last year. So, again, we're going to have a great competition. There's no question about that. We do have some good experience. We've played some redshirt freshman guys and freshman guys this past season. So I think we'll have the right people in there. I think we'll have a little bit more depth. We just need to make sure they can stay healthy.
Stay on the offensive side, running back-wise, you've taken one running back in each of the last three classes, Hickson, Lewis last year. Now, Boyd, is that something where you want to bring in a guy who can have some explosiveness, be a complete back, so that way you can have a good rotation each year without having to graduate multiple guys at the same year?
I mean, we talk about that, and I think, going into next season, you know, we're going to have two guys who are going to be seniors there, and Todd Macon there and Carrington Mosley. And so in that aspect, we want to make sure we got somebody in this class so we have a little bit of separation. We always can find good backs, then we're going to go after them. And, again, we got to always look at what we have scholarship-wise and what we got going on. But he was a tremendous athlete and a tremendous running back, and he was just somebody we just want to make sure that we can get in the program since he had some strong interest in us.
You mentioned a few guys individually that you think might have a chance to play as a true freshman. Any specific positions that you look for some immediate help? Obviously, tight end. Any others?
I think the only position that probably right off my bat would say tight ends. I consider and say we're probably going to play one for sure. And may play both of them. I don't know. Again, they got to be ready to play, but I can say one for sure. We're going to have to probably get him ready to go do some things of that nature. And then all the other positions, you know, they come in here if they have a chance to compete and be on special teams and have a chance to be a backup or somewhere at a position, and then we'll play them. And I'm definitely open to playing true freshmen, even though they may not be a starter as far as the offensive or defensive side of the ball.
DJ Stubbs, a guy reportedly a three-star recruit. Do you kind of compare him a little bit to a Zach Parker? I mean, they're about the same size. Is there any comparison there, or who would you compare him to?
Well, I guess you can probably say that because of the size. They're similar in ways. I think he's a little bit more burst, change of direction once he makes a cut. Being able to make a burst and go forward and do some great things from that aspect of it. So there is some similarities, but again, I think he has that same skill set as far as punt returner, and we're going to give him a shot to see what he can do, and he'll be able to compete for that, and we'll go from there.
Welcome you back into the Game On Studios. Those were the words of Liberty head coach Turner Gill. He talked about this signing class here in 2017, and Alan, the first thing that jumped out to me right away, he pointed to the football IQ. And you know the staff is going to get athletes. You know they're going to get speed. When you get that football IQ to go along with it, you feel like you're almost one step ahead of the game when you got guys that understand and have a deep understanding of the game as soon as they step foot on campus.
Matt, it seems like each and every year as recruiting gets more in depth, you get kids that can contribute right away.
Yeah.
And they want to contribute right away. And so when you talk to them, as Coach said, we put them all on the chalkboard when they're on their visits, and they were running plays for us. And so it just shows you how talented these kids are and what fun families they come from as well.
Yeah, how quickly can they contribute is always the question. We'll ask that question along with some others as we talk to the guys that have been out on the recruiting trail. The assistant coaches join us next to break down this entire class on this 2017 Flame Signing Day special.
So you've chosen Liberty University. What's next? Well, you could study here, or here.
Or way out here.
You could build this, catch that, or play this. Sure, you'll have early mornings, long days, and some longer nights. But that's how we grow. No matter who you are, where you live, or what you want to do, your education starts here.
Welcome back to our 2017 Liberty Flames Signing Day Special. Alan York joined now by offensive line coach Aaron Stammen. Let's talk a little bit about a couple of kids you already have incoming out. One of them is already on campus, Tristan Schultz from Fork Union, originally from Culver, Indiana, one of two offensive linemen in this class.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Tristan's from a real tiny town in Indiana. I had to be going there to get there to go meet him and his parents.
Any cornfields you go through?
Yeah. Lot. And there was also snow and everything too, on the way from Chicago. But it was a great trip. I got a chance to sit down with him for quite a while in his house. And it was a really cool commitment because I didn't know he was going to do it. And by the end of the night, at about 2 hours in his house, all of a sudden he looked at me right before I went out the door and said, I'm in. So he's got a great mentality. He's a tough guy. He's hitting people, an offensive lineman, which is a big quality.
All right, we're going to head over to the desk right now and check in with Matt Warner.
Yeah, standing over here with Kyle DeArmon, wide receivers coach. Coach, first of all, congrats on the new position here on the coaching staff. Yeah, swing on over. Join us, won't you? Talking about this wide receiver class. Two kids you have coming in. First up, Caleb Coleman, kid out of the D.C. area, 13 touchdowns as a senior. That jumps off the page right away. What can you tell us about this young man?
Yeah, no doubt. You know, Coach Stam did a great job going up to D.C. and recruiting Caleb. You know, Caleb came in during the season and just took a visit and then came in last weekend on his official. But he's been committed for a while for us. And, you know, he's a kid that is tall and long, but he has quick feet, and his skill set is good for him to be outside receiver in the slot. He can do a lot for us. He's a guy who we expect to do some big things here at Liberty.
You like the length, but when you add the quick feet, not just a big body,
right,
but you say he's got some quickness to his
game
as well.
Right. Usually some of those big guys, you know, they are long striders and they can run, but they lack the ability sometimes to get off the line of scrimmage right away or to make people miss. But Caleb has all of those skill sets, and I think we got a steal, and I think that just credit to Coach Stam, did a really, really good job recruiting him. Coach Brown, they did a really good job getting Caleb down here and committing.
Now, the other wide receiver you have, DJ Stubbs, kid out of Jacksonville, played basically every position on the field, it sounds like, during his high school career. 5'9", smaller, quicker receiver. How would you describe his game?
Yeah, you know, DJ is very, very explosive. He was a guy at University Christian that Coach Penland, they wanted to get him the ball any way they could, from quarterback to running back, punt returner, kick returner, receiver. Anytime they could get the ball in his hands, it was a good thing for them on offense. And they won back-to-back state championships. So, you know, he comes in with a winning mentality right away. But he's a guy that we can do a lot with. You know, hopefully he can come in and be that punt return guy that we need, and at the same time, too, do a lot for us on offense. You know, I know Coach Daly's really excited about having him in the offense, to be able to move him around and just get him the ball.
The depth that you have of the wide receiver position, you add these two to what you have coming back. Is this as deep a group as you've seen in a while?
Yeah, this is probably, we'll probably have 15 guys in the fall, and I've already talked to him about the competition this spring, and with the addition of Caleb and DJ in the fall, this is definitely the deepest group that it's been since I've been here. I'm just looking for him to compete, and we'll see what happens. But it's the deepest group, and hopefully, you know, we can play a lot of guys and be fresh and make some things happen.
Yeah, last thing, you know, the wide receiver position inside and out, that competition and that kind of depth, how much better does it make the guys because they're competing constantly with a deep group?
Oh yeah, for sure. I mean, that in of itself is something that just creates those guys who were starters last year to push a little bit harder in the offseason, because they know that those guys who are a two or a three, you know, they've gotten better, and they'll just continue to push those starters. And, you know, some guys may take other positions, and so that competition just pushes everybody.
Coach, congratulations
Thank
on
you.
That. A couple of playmakers. Thanks for stopping by.
No problem. Thank
Alan,
you.
Send it back over to you.
All right, Matt, appreciate it. Again, joined by offensive line coach Aaron Stam. And two guys in this signing class. One's already on campus. We talked about Tristan Schultz just a little bit from Fork Union by way of Culver, Indiana. Yep. Tell us a bit more about Tristan.
Recruiting trip with Tristan. He'd been on campus for a game and went to Fork Union out of high school because his high school was really small and just did not get recruited much. Went up to Indiana and met with him and his parents, and got to see a bunch of snowfall and everything on the way, and I had to be going there to get there because it was about 2 hours and change from Chicago, and had a great visit. And after about 2 hours, he just decided to commit, and it was great, just sitting in at home. But Tristan loves football. He is a gritty, grindy guy. You can see on the video. He will run through a brick wall for you if he knows that that's what you want him to do. And he's already started workouts with our team, with Coach Gillespie, and excited to have him on campus.
You hear kids about getting to the next level. Mm-hmm. Tell us about Schultz and in doing that, and also Cooper McCall out of Southlake, Texas.
Tristan, he was real patient with everything because, he was probably frustrated a little bit out of high school because he just didn't really get a whole lot of recruiting. But it ended up working out for him. And he's got a great situation because really he's got 5.5 years if it needs to be, because he starts mid-semester. So I'm happy he's here, and he's raring to go. So,
Cooper McCaw, Coach talked about, has been on campus 3 times already.
Yeah.
So that's a kid that really wants to be a Liberty Flame.
It was a great school. He goes to Faith Christian High School down in Grapevine, Texas, and that school is actually a school that Liberty has talked about on a daily and weekly basis. And got a chance to go in and visit with his coach, Chris Hogan, and he couldn't have been more ecstatic that our university was there. And Cooper's great. He loves football. He's a smart guy. And he got lineman of the year, I think, for his high school. He was first team All-State guy in Texas. They won the state championship. He loves playing O-line, and he just can't wait to get here. He did come to camp also, too, this summer as well.
And Aaron, how about your move to O-line coach? How excited are you to get with the group?
I'm jacked. I feel like I'm 22 again. So.
Good stuff. We appreciate your time and look forward to following the progress of Cooper McCall and Tristan Schultz. Thank you.
Me too.
All right, let's move back to the desk. Once again, let's join Matt.
Yeah, thank you, AY. Joined now by Scott Downing, of course, coaching special teams, as we know, also tight ends and fullbacks. We appreciate you stopping by. Of course, a Kansas City guy, so we have a special connection.
Obviously.
We always talk about that. Tight end, you lose a lot from last year. You need to kind of restock the shelves. You feel like you've done that with this class. Two kids coming in. First off, tell me a little bit about Jerome Jackson.
Well, Jerome is from the Dallas-Fort Worth area. That's Coach Stamm's recruiting area. And he did a great job of locating him and then kind of a team recruit going in and getting him interested. But the thing I love the most about Jerome is he just loves football. He loves to play the game. He loves to work at it. He's diligent in his preparation. And he's a great kid. Comes from a great family. His dad was 28 years in the U.S. Army.
Wow.
And so, he's got discipline
home. That's right.
But he was fun. He was here a week ago, last weekend, and committed to us. And we're just excited to have him because I think he brings not only his enthusiasm for the game and his love for the game, but great work ethic. He's got a great catch radius, long arms. Yeah. He's a long, tall guy. He's going to do nothing but get bigger and stronger and better as he plays for us.
Yeah, that's scary when he's already got that 6'5 frame.
Yeah.
That's a scary thing to think about, for teams going up against you guys. The other guy, Brian Fidel Obafin, a tight end that I know you folks are really excited to get him on campus.
Yeah, we were. We really were. Fidel is from the Atlanta area, and we had located him last spring. And knew a lot about him, and were able to watch him this fall. We actually, when we played Kennesaw State, went down.
Okay, yeah.
And Coach Stamm got to go over and watch him play physically and came back. And, again, same types of things that Jerome brings to the table. Fidel also brings just some tremendous speed and burst and explosiveness. When he gets the ball in his hand is when you better start watching because something highlight type reel is going to happen because he just does some great stuff. Both of these guys have caught a lot of passes. Fidel was really, for his team, Douglas County High School, he was the number one receiver on their team. So they split him out, put him one-on-one into the boundary a lot, and he delivered a lot of yardage for them and a lot of big catches. So we're excited to have him on board.
We're seeing that more and more at all levels. The tight end is kind of, that position is becoming more of a playmaker. We're certainly seeing that at the NFL level. You see these guys as being guys that not just, 5 yards over the middle, but these are guys that can break one and make big plays down the
field. Oh, yeah, absolutely. Because what we're seeing in the high schools is high school coaches are spreading them out a little bit. They're putting them out in space, and they're getting them matchups with a athletic big guy against maybe smaller linebackers or certainly smaller DBs, and they're catching the ball, breaking a tackle, and now they're running down the field, and they've got a head of steam, and they're running over people and making huge, huge plays. And both Jerome and Fidel have that capability. But they're both guys, like Coach Gill said earlier today, smart guys. They're both smart in the classroom, and they're smart on the football field. And you know, again, they just love playing the game, and we're excited to get them here this summer. Absolutely. And let's see what they can do.
Well, Coach, congrats on a great signing class.
Thank
and
you.
Always good to see you.
Good to see you. We'll get some barbecue on us.
Let's do it. Hey, we're just getting warmed up. Much more ahead on this 2017 Flame Signing Day Special.
For more than four decades, Liberty University has been redefining success by molding leaders who believe in living out their calling with integrity. We don't just focus on how something is done, but why it should be done. As an accredited liberal arts institution, Liberty offers a broad range of opportunities, balancing academic theory, research, and hands-on training. Liberty's classroom extends well beyond the borders of our campus to a global community of online students who have access to the same quality education as our on-campus students. Excellence at Liberty also plays out on the field through 20 NCAA Division I teams, 35 club sports teams. Our faith inspires us to understand the world around us. Liberty graduates leave here prepared for more than a career. They leave prepared for life. Be more at Liberty University.
What's the Big South?
What's the Big South?
What's the Big South?
It's our home.
It's our home.
Rooted in excellence.
Built from hard work.
It's our backbone.
An undeniable will.
Driven to surpass our potential.
It's our heart.
Unbreakable bonds.
And our journey.
Striving for more.
Determined to lead.
Day in and day out.
This is the Big South.
Where winners are made.
Welcome back to our 2017 Liberty Flames Signing Day Special. Alan York, Matt Warner, now joined by linebackers coach Josh Bookbinder. Book, good to see you.
Hey, guys. Great to see you.
Yeah, thanks for stopping by.
Pleasure to have both of you.
You know, it took two of us to match your wits here on set, so that's why we did this.
You're the only coach that gets two of us.
That's right.
I'm honored.
I don't know if you need the help or
that
works.
It's
All right, let's talk about these linebackers you have coming in, beginning with Remington Green, Virginia kid. What do you like about his game? What do you see him kind of developing into here as a Flame?
Well, Remington is a Virginia kid. It was great to get a kid out of the state of Virginia. King George, Virginia. Coach Singletary did a great job identifying and recruiting him. And he's actually a kid we said, hey, come to campus this summer, come to camp. Worked him out in the summer and just love the passion this kid brings. You can see on his highlights, he's going to hit you and hit you hard. So he's a kid that brings that energy and intensity to the linebacker position. Also a good student. And we actually affectionately referred to him as the mayor of 2017 because he was the first guy on board, came in.
He's
and,
been tweeting for months. Yeah, he's all over the place.
He's been a recruiter for us for this class. So we love having him on board.
And how about Amari Jenkins? 6 feet, 195 out of Ocala, Florida.
Yeah, Amari's a kid that we got on during the season. Coach Wimberly went down Ocala, Florida, kind of a rural area, and identified Amari. He was playing safety, so he's a guy that we look at and say, hey, this kid can come in with a frame to put on some weight. Coach Bill down in the weight room does a great job developing these guys, so he's going to develop into a nice linebacker. He's got some coverage ability coming from the safety spot. Some long arms, kid that we're really excited about. His mom was a pleasure to be around, as all these guys' families are. So, glad to get him up too.
He was a kid I saw 4 interceptions as a senior. 3 of them he took back to the house. So yeah. When he gets his hand on the football, he knows what he's doing with it.
He's a confident football player, and he also plays basketball. So we went and watched him play basketball. He's a dual sport athlete. So yeah, when he gets his hands on the ball, he's confident with it and can provide some juice that way too. So
you hear a lot about linebackers, Josh, that can run sideline to sideline. Where do these two guys stack up?
Yeah, I think that was one of the qualities that we look for in both of them, and they can both do that. Remington showed that when he came to camp and worked out with us, and also on film, being relentless. And then Amari, from the safety spot, he naturally covers a little more ground. They put him back there deep in the middle of the field, so you can see him cover ground. Definitely a quality we look for when we're recruiting.
You want a little edge, a little swagger at that position. Just watching film, and you only get so much, I know, but it looks like these guys have that.
Yeah, you got to have confidence when you step on the field. We talk about that all the time. I think it starts with being prepared, but when you're prepared, you go on the field, you know you're going to make plays. It brings the confidence, and we want guys that play like that.
All right, Josh, appreciate the time.
Yeah. Thank you, guys.
If you guys don't mind, I'm going to head out this way. You mind? I'm just going
to
do a little walk and talk. You see if they come on over, stay with me. I'm going to talk to one of our favorite guys now, Vance Singletary, defensive line coach. Coach, thanks for waiting on me over here.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. You always seem to get a couple of guys that we talk about them on this day, and then don't you know it, fall comes around and they're making plays on the field. Do you feel like you kind of have a couple of guys like that that could potentially be those guys here quickly?
I got 2 great guys that just love mixing it up.
Yeah.
Play 5, love to get after it, very intelligent, great football IQ. Let's go.
Let's talk first about Elisha Mitchell, kid at Virginia Beach. What do you like about his game? Where do you see him fitting in along the line?
Wide body.
Yeah.
Physical, nasty, tough. I mean, reminds me of a Mean Joe Green.
Throwing out that name.
Yes, yes.
Watch a little bit of his film. Quickly, you see him breaking out this swim move, just swimming right on by offensive linemen. Is he, as far as that goes and kind of the pass rushing techniques he has, do you feel like he's a little bit advanced in that sense?
He is. You know, he, visiting with his coach, just talked about his mechanics and how he teaches and picks up things. Love, you know, just kind of doing all the little things. And it's hard, you know, grabbing a big fella like that out of high school and asking him to come right in and, you know, picking things up and going out and mixing it up.
The other guy bringing in J.I. Sanders out of Tallahassee, we heard Coach Hill's press conference say he was really excited. That's the equivalent of Coach Hill doing backflips or something. He doesn't just praise guys like that, you know, every day. So he's excited about this kid. What does he bring to the table?
Quickness.
Yeah.
Speed. I mean, just kind of does all the little things. Very smart, coachable, exciting. He brings a lot. I'm thrilled and tickled to death.
6'3", 210 is J.I. Sanders. And you look at it and you say, well, 210, you know, he'll probably fill out a bit. I went back and looked at my notes a couple years ago. Some kid named Jawan Wells came in at 215. It didn't take him long to start wreaking havoc there on that defensive line. Is this a kid, I don't know if you want to compare their games, but that quickness, and do you see him being able to fill out a little bit more and explode like we've seen some other guys do?
He will, with the help of our strength and conditioning coach, Bill Gillespie. I mean, he's excited to get a hold of this guy and put some good weight on him. And the kid's already working hard. Can't wait to get our workout and conditioning book. He puts me in the mind of a Chima Uzoway.
Oh, yeah, that's another
big
name.
And a Jawan Wells. Yeah. So those guys, he's a combination of those two kids.
So you got the wide body in the middle. You got the speed on the edge. That, I mean, you check. You're good. This recruiting class, you're ready to rock.
Oh, I can't wait. I can't wait. I'm excited.
Well, we're excited, too. Coach, we appreciate you stopping by.
Thank you.
Can't wait to see what they do this fall.
Thank you,
Always
sir.
Always a pleasure. All right, Alan, send it back over to you.
All right, thanks a lot, Matt. Let's go to the back end now with cornerbacks coach Marshall Roberts, and that's tough to beat. We've got Mean Joe Green and Chima, two references of a couple of really good defensive players.
Sure.
But you have control of the back end on the cornerback spot. Let's talk about two guys, Keith Best. Coach Gill, everybody calls this guy maybe the steal of the class. A lot of FBS offers. A little bit injured right now, but he's on the mend. Yeah. So, Keith Best, what can you tell us about him?
You know what? Coach Singletary and Coach Wimberly really did a great job with this kid down at Tucker. We really loved on him and let him know that we were willing to invest our time, our resources, and you know, our coaching and our ability to model, teach, train, and mentor this young man. And he's very unique. He has all the ability and skill sets that it takes to be very special at the position.
I remember talking to you a couple of years ago when Chris Turner first got on campus. You were speechless. Your eyes got really big. Coach Gill kind of talked to us about Keith Best. Mm-hmm. He's a young version of Chris Turner. So when you think of those comparisons, we all know how good Chris Turner is. Uh-huh. How good can Keith Best be?
Well, the sky's the limit. I mean, his body is really more developed than what Chris's was when he first got here. And this kid's going to be a big, physical, athletic kid. It's going to be fun to coach him.
You hear a lot about not only the kids, but the families, and getting the families on campus and talking to them. How important is that in this process?
That's unbelievably important because you get to see the way they've been trained, the way they've been taught, where they come from, what their background is, the great things about the young man, and then you have to know the not-so-great things about a young man. So getting to know the family, really getting to know the kid and how he's hardwired is super important.
And the second guy, Kamani Donaldson out of Jonesboro, Georgia.
Yeah, I love Kamani.
Yeah.
Kamani's smart. Kamani is very good academically. He is physical. He's probably one of the most physical guys in this class. He'll come down, he'll knock you out. And I'm really excited about him because his ceiling, his upside, there's no telling how good he's going to be because he's got all the intangibles that let us know he's going to be pretty good.
Coach Gill also talked about his ball skills. When you hear that reference, what are we talking about?
Oh, man. Well, see, he played some wide receiver, but the year before, he had most of the interceptions. This year, they stayed away from him. But he has the ability to make a play. I don't want to lead the nation in PBUs. We want interceptions. Mm-hmm. We want the ball to change and give it back to our offense. So he has that ability to cover somebody, but also finish with an interception. That's ball skills.
Last year, 26 takeaways. Can this back end be as good in 2017?
Oh, there's no doubt. And it's not really all about the back end. It's about that front end.
Yeah.
You get some pressure up there and that ball goes up in the air. Half of those interceptions are because of the D-line.
All right, Marshall. Always good seeing you and have a great spring, okay?
Thanks.
Let's head back to the other island. Here's Matt again.
Yeah, thanks, AY. Standing by here with Robert Wimberly, defensive coordinator, also coaches the safeties, and that's what we're going to talk about now. You got one safety in this class, Aaron Pierre, kid out of Florida. What do you like about him and what he brings to the table there in that safety spot?
Well, it all starts with Coach Brown. He brought him to our attention in the summer, and the young man had great dialogue with him. And what stood out is he came on campus with his dad and his younger brother, Kyle, who I call Baby Magic, had the opportunity to watch him play basketball. And the young man recently gave his life to Christ.
Wow.
And so on the visit, you know, he really fell in love with our staff. We fell in love with him. Coach Gill did a great job. And the young man was actually headed to another university and told his dad, I think I found my home. So he committed to us in the summer and stayed true to that commitment. And to me, that means a lot when you have a lot of FBS mid-major schools coming in and saying, Coach Dare, why is this young man not entertaining us? And I think it's because of that relationship.
That speaks a lot about him. It speaks a lot about you and the staff as well, certainly here at Liberty. A kid that had two uncles that played in the NFL. I know you don't necessarily look for those bloodlines, but that's not a bad thing when you have that kind of football talent in the family.
No doubt the pedigree.
Yeah.
You know, as I stated, this young man is a physical football player. And his mindset is to hurt people in the right way.
That's right. No, you gotta
but,
add that.
You know, when you watch his film, you can see he does not leave the field. He's on offense. He's on special teams. He's actually had multiple kickoff returns for touchdowns. He can run. He's actually doing track right now.
Okay.
So he loves to play the game. And like you said, I think it is a bloodline that he has with that mindset.
And you mentioned him as a person, school ambassador, the Little League football coach I saw, the right kind of person that you want in this program.
You know, our whole motto is we're trying to find young men that want to be a part of Liberty, that we can build a relationship with, that we're going to respect, and they respect us. Like I said, both parents came in on the the official visit here and fell in love with us, and we fell in love with them. So we're excited about this young man and his career here at Liberty.
Excited to see him on the field. Coach, we appreciate the
Thank
time,
you.
As always. When we come back, we talk running back and quarterback on this Flames Signing Day special.
So you've chosen Liberty University. What's next? Well, you could study here or here.
or way out here.
You could build this, catch that, or play this. Sure, you'll have early mornings, long days, and some longer nights. But that's how we grow. No matter who you are, where you live, or what you want to do, your education starts here.
Moving right along on our Liberty Flames signing day special, Alan York now joined by running backs coach Ron Brown. Coach, thanks for taking time out of your schedule to join us. Put it there, big guy. All right, Frank Boyd, running back out of Midlothian, Virginia, Chesterfield, Virginia, which is in the area outside of Richmond. So tell us about him.
Well, our offensive staff did a nice job of just looking for the right kind of people on offense. And running backs come a dime a dozen around the country, as we all know. But running back has to be able to handle three areas: the first level, the second level, which is where the linebackers are, the third level, where the safeties are. You find a lot of the running backs can get past the line of scrimmage, make the second level miss, but they get tackled a lot by the third level. Frank Boyd had the ability on film over and over and over again to beat the third level and to take it to the house. He's got track speed, runs on the track team, and we wanted a guy that could take it the distance. So we're excited about this young man.
One thing I noticed too is vision on Frank. He's got speed north and south, not east and west.
Yeah.
And so when he sees a hole, he makes one little slip cut and he's out the door. How important is vision when it comes to running back?
That was something we talked about with him. He has very nice vision. And a running back has got to be able to see. He's looking here. He's got to be able to see what's happening over here. And so Frank had the ability to make backside A-gap runs, jump cuts, and put his foot down in the ground and have some definition. Put his foot, go north, and then again with a breakaway speed. I like his length, too. I think Coach Bill Gillespie is going to be able to put some meat on him because he's got very long arms, very long body, a little taller than the average running back. So he's maybe about 180 right now. He's going to be a good 200, 205 pounds before it's all done, I think.
Ron, you inherit a very deep position entering this fall. What does it take for a new kid to kind of get into the mix and kind of get his feet wet?
I think the running back has got to be the toughest war daddy on the field. I mean, he's a Navy SEAL. Everybody wants what he has, that ball. And he's got to move the chains. He's got to advance and matriculate the ball down the field. And so I want to see how tough he is, how tough-minded he is. I know he's got skills. But this group of running backs, one thing, he's coming into a group with Simo, Todd, Frankie, that group right there, they're tough kids.
Yep.
If they're not only physically tough kids, but they're mentally tough kids. Great off-season kids. That's a great group for him to be around. And Frank has had a great support unit with mom and family, that the coaching staff, Coach Hall at Manchester High School, the guidance counselors, the school administration. He's used to an offensive line off the field. He'll have a good one here, I believe, but he'll have a good group of guys, good support structure around him to get him going in the right direction.
Great support from you as well. You're always in game mode, ready to go right now. Ron, we appreciate your time.
I thank the Lord. Thank you very much. Thanks for having me.
All right, that's Ron Brown. Matt, over to you.
Yeah, thanks, AY. Standing by now with Joe Daly, offensive coordinator, quarterback's coach. We're going to talk quarterback right now. You got a kid out of JUCO, Mason Cunningham, out of Tennessee originally, but went to Northeast Mississippi Community College last year. First off, tell me, that 1 year under his belt, how much of a difference does that make for him now coming into your program?
Well, it just gives him opportunity, really, to come in ready to compete, you know, early on. He was a young man, really, that was under recruit to come out of high school and actually had something going with Tennessee Tech, and then he dropped him last minute. And so he had decided to go the JUCO route, and we're just fortunate enough that we came upon him early enough to be able to jump in the boat and actively, you know, pursue him.
1,800 yards passing, 12 touchdowns, 6 rushing touchdowns last year at the JUCO level. Is he a dual threat guy? Is he more of a drop back pro style passer? Describe his game.
We would consider him more of a dual threat guy.
Okay.
He has decent athleticism with a really, really strong arm. And so the combination of those two things give you an opportunity to call plays where, you know, he's not just back there throwing the football.
Yeah.
There's an opportunity for him to carry the football, you know, in the run game and obviously be, you know, a threat scrambling as well.
This kid's a mid-year enrollee as well. Mm-hmm. What you tell me, especially the quarterback position, Is that even more important if you can get them on campus a semester early to kind of get them used to what you're saying, to the words you're using, to how you run your offense?
Yes, sir, very much so. This will be the second year in a row that we've signed a kid that was a mid-year guy. And getting him here in the spring, you know, is vital to his growth. To be able to, you know, really get 15 practices under us before we ever go into fall camp is huge, in addition to you know, the strength conditioning, you know, component that Bill Gillespie and his staff puts together gives these guys an opportunity to be ready to play come August.
We heard Coach Hill say Stephon Mascha, no longer a quarterback, move him out to wide receiver. You bring in Cunningham. Talk about the depth you have at the quarterback position.
Yeah, so now we'll have four quarterbacks. We move Spencer Jones as well to the wide out position. Yep. So now we have Buckshot Calvert. We'll have Rudd Yerick.
Yep.
We'll have Mason Cunningham and have David Jeremiah. So we'll have four different quarterbacks in the room. And we're excited about those guys because they're all really smart guys, great, you know, football intelligence. And there's a natural leadership amongst that unit. So we're really, really excited about those guys.
Coach, we appreciate you stopping by. Exciting times ahead. Can't wait for the season to get going.
Yes, sir. Thanks for having me.
Thanks for coming. Good all right. You. Tell you what, I'm going to head back over this way. We did the walk over here, so we'll walk it on back. Alan York is patiently awaiting my return. AY, we talked to all these guys. We have introduced you now to all the recruits in this 2017 class. Biggest takeaway from what we've heard here today?
I think how excited this coaching staff is for this class. It seems like it happens every year. The excitement keeps growing and growing and growing. And for this class coming into 2017, it's opportunity. We talked about how the kids want to play it right away. Well, they've got opportunities to do that. And this coaching staff has proven that under Coach Gill's leadership, that if you work hard, you will play. And if you're talented enough, you will play. I know it takes a lot of talent to get on the field, but this class seems very deep and very balanced from the numbers-wise and position-wise.
You like to, you fill some spots where you feel like, all right, we graduated a bunch of guys at this position. You can't necessarily always find guys that you feel like can really step in and fill those roles, or maybe you do and you feel like we just got to recruit this position because we're losing some guys. It seems like they've got not just guys to fill those spots, they've got talent to fill those spots, especially you talk about the tight end position. Exciting with those two athletes that they have coming in. And again, we just heard Joe Daly talk about it. You need that depth of the quarterback position. You're one play away from looking down that bench and seeing who's next. To have a guy come in Mason Cunningham that has a year under his belt playing at the JUCO level, you like the depth that they've added certainly in this class as well.
And the fun thing about this time of year is you're 0-0. You can play with some parts. Mm-hmm. And for Stephon Mascha, who we've talked about, has been around here for 4+ years and who has meant so much to the program. Just go back a couple of years, 2014, helping Liberty get to the playoffs. And now, being a senior, you could have that ego and say, you know what, I'm done. I'm going to go do something else. No. But he wants to graduate as a Flame and continue building this program to what we all expect it to be. So it's neat to kind of hear the stories of, okay, what's been going on under the hood since November, and now we're starting to hear these stories and to see the excitement from the coaches. It's palpable, that's for sure.
You start thinking about this next season. I know coaches, they're not there yet, right? There's a long way to go before we get to that point. But you start thinking about the playmakers this team has coming back at running back, at wide receiver. You start thinking about, you know, the defensive line, and you're always getting big-time production from that group. You start getting ready. Can we go play right now? Can we lace them up right now? You and I are ready. The coaches are probably like, let's get a few practices under our belts here. But exciting group as we move forward into next season.
It is. And you and I have been around the kids, you know, for years now. And it's exciting to see. I remember last year Solomon McGinty was here how excited he was to be on campus and just how fresh the attitude was. And so that's kind of what we see right now with signing day in the rearview mirror as we move on to the spring.
Well, hopefully this gets all of you a little bit excited too for football. Still have a little ways to go, but you got a taste of what this team and this program can expect in the future. This has been the Flames Signing Day Special. For Alan York, I'm Matt Warner. Plan on seeing you out at Williams Stadium sometime this fall. Have a great night.